All right. New surroundings. Same show. predictions for the Rich Franklin, or the, pardon me, Kung Lee Michael Bisping card and the Henderson Dos Anjos card, or Dos Anjos card. I'm really off my game today. Sorry, guys. It's just been one of those days. Okay, so quickly we'll talk about the card that's on Fight Pass, headlined by Michael Bisping and Kung Lee. And specifically the only two fights on the card that I give a flying crap about. Dong Hoon Kim versus Tyrone Woodley. Both guys are grappling-based fighters who have branched out and become other things. In fact, somewhat in a lot of ways known for other things even more. What the hell is that? Yeah, whatever. Barbecue sauce, I think. Who do I think is going to win the fight? When it comes down to it, I'm not really a big believer in Tyrone Woodley. I've never really been. I mean, yes, he got the victory. He was looking good against Carlos Condit. Then Carlos Condit hurt himself, got the victory there. Did pretty well against Jake Shields, but we've been through the utterly every actual contender should be able to deal with that. And then got embarrassed by Rory McDonald. He has good knockout power. He has fantastic athleticism. But he suffers from serious game plan problems. And that is when he comes out, and if his game plan doesn't immediately work, or the opponent can adjust to a game plan that disrupts his, he does very, very poorly with it. Dong Hoon Kim, a little bit different in the sense that we have seen him shut down by game plans before, and particularly does have a struggling time when he can't take people down. That being said, we're still talking about a guy who is a gamer. He'll take shots, he'll go in there, he'll show toughness, kind of brawl it out, kind of do a lot of things that Nate Marquardt did to Tyrone Woodley that Woodley had problems with. As a result, I'm going to go with Dong Hoon Kim by, we'll say decision, but a win for Woodley via decision would not be surprising, nor would a knockout be really surprising. Michael Bisping versus Kung Lee. Both guys are past their best before date. To be honest, I don't think we ever got to see Kung Lee before his best before date. I'm going with Bisping here. Kung Lee brings a good striking game to the table, but, you know, realistically speaking, he's not tremendously diverse. He throws different shots, don't get me wrong in that regard, but you know what he's going to do. He's going to go out there, he's going to play the San Chiao game. He's not really going to be interested in the ground game, and I think Bisping can do a good job of mixing it up using his own striking to set up takedowns, and also cardio has always been a question for Kung Lee, in my opinion. Bisping doesn't have that problem. He did disappoint me by losing Tim Kennedy, but I'm going Bisping here. You know what? I'll go weird here. I'll say he submits in like the fourth or fifth round, somewhere there. All right. Now, the more interesting card that's on the same day, we have Fox Sports 1 card, UFC Fight Night, Henderson versus Dos Anjos. Wilson Hayes versus Joey Sanchez, the only Fight Pass card. Joby Sanchez, pardon me. This was supposed to be originally Tim Elliott, and I was really looking forward to that fight. But with this fight, I'm going with Wilson Hayes to win via a naked choke, probably. but submission, anyways. Ben Saunders' return to the UFC is against Chris Heatherly. Good. I'm in for a violence fest from Ben Saunders, probably with a TKO victory. Aaron Phillips, Matt Hobar. Neither guy do I'm not a tremendous fan of the guy. I'm going to go Matt Hobart by decision. You know, I'm kind of skipping over some of these because they're not really all that interesting undercard, but they're more interesting than the other card that is going on this day. Benil Darouche, Tony Martin. I was really excited for Benil Darouche after the Charlie Brenneman fight, but then he got pretty well embarrassed by Ramzy Najem, so I'm going to go with Tony Martin to win a... Let's go with submission. Neil Magny versus Alex Garcia. Alex Garcia needs to do something in this fight very early on. Neil Magny tends to get stronger as the fight goes on. And Alex Garcia tends to get weaker. But early on, I think Garcia's got really all the tools to make this happen. Magny has always seemed to be a guy who fights with good technique, learns very quickly every time out. He's showing a little new wrinkle to his game. but at the same time doesn't really have that explosive. He's not slow, but just that ability to explode, that ability to change the speed and just overwhelm. Alex Garcia's got that in spades. I'm going with Alex Garcia by TKO. Chad Skelly versus Tom Minimaki. Very excited about this fight. Oh, yes. Chad Skelly was disappointing in his debut. I've been talking about this guy for a long time, and to see him lose to Mirsad Bektik was not good. Obviously, Tom Nidamaki on the other end. I was not hyped up for his debut. And then he went in and beat Ronnie Yaya and lost to Nicholas Baxter. I'm going with Chad Skelly here by decision. These two guys are very good grapplers, very good wrestlers. They have some stand-up game. I believe he can get this done. James Vick versus Valmer Lazaro. Don't really know him, so I'm going to go with a non-pick. Although James Vick is an exciting prospect, so look for possibly a knockout there. Max Holloway versus Clay Collard. This was also a really good fight. It was going to be... Oh, this was going to be Mirsad Bektik. Also on this card, fighting Max Holloway. I'm really looking forward to that. I'm not looking forward to this one. Max Holloway by TKO. Francis Carmo versus Talos Latus. Francis Carmo is going to get Francis Carmo in this fight by Talos Latus. Who's a better grappler, a better striker. Just a better fighter, period. Latest. If he doesn't get a submission, decision. But I'm gonna say submission. Mike Pyle versus Jordan Mean. Very excited for this fight. Right up there with Chad Skelly versus Tom Minimaki fight. I'm going with Mean, and the reason for it is Mike Pyle is starting to show his age. I mean, he's coming off a win against TJ Wahlberger. But it seemed like a fight that should have been easier. He arguably lost the fight with Rick Story. He lost to Matt Brown. He did have a nice run before that with Ricardo Funch, Josh Neer, and James Head. And, of course, before that, some good fights against John Hathaway and so on. I just think Mean has the tools to get him done. Mean's been hit or miss in the octagon, to be honest. He got crushed, of course, by Matt Brown after his debut where he destroyed Dan Miller and then beat Hernani Perpetuo in what looks like a fight that probably shouldn't have been as competitive as it was based on Perpetuo's subsequent fights. But I just have to go with the youth here. Pyle, I think, is getting to the point where he's just too old to play the game that he likes to play, which is a somewhat open striking game. It's technical. It's not a brawly style. But he'll use openings, and you would think the man with the speed of Mean can get this done. Jordan Mean beat TKO. But I wouldn't be surprised that way. Pyle's got the ability to finish Mean, without a doubt. And then, of course, the main event. Ooh, excuse me. Benson Henderson versus Rafael Dos Anjos. Rafael Dos Anjos, last time out, looked great, but it was against Jason High. Let's be honest. Yes, the win against Donald Cerrone and Evan Dunham really had his skyrocketing, but then he got beat by Kerman Nurmagomedov. I really see Henderson being able to do some of the same things Nurmagomedov did to him. Control him, take him down, put him on his back if need be. And I don't see his striking troubling him. As much as I'm not a fan of Benson Henderson, I'm not a fan of watching his fights even. He's had some exciting ones, but it takes another guy to make it exciting. And it's not the lack of finishes, because I didn't find the Houston Havilov fight, which he did finish, to be tremendously exciting. That being said, I can't deny the man's amazing skills within the current rule set and the current ability and the current crop of the fighters. And he can play a game plan. He can get the win here, probably. Probably by decision, because I don't see him finishing Dos Anjos. It's not a bad card. But it's a card that definitely got hit by the injury bug very late. I mean, we lost Tim Elliott versus Wilson Hayes, which I was really looking forward to. We lost Max Holloway versus Mirsad Bektik, which I was also really looking forward to. It's a bit disappointing. Just some quick notes here on two things. One, the whole random wife violence in MMA is being taken way out of proportion and being way overcovered. It's a sad thing to say, but this happens in life all the time. And It's only when it's to someone's agenda to throw it out there and shine light on it. It's another thing I want to do. I'm thinking about doing a series of videos called Myths of MMA, talking about common misconceptions in regards to the sport with its own fan base and also with outsiders. Let me know if you guys would like to actually hear that, because if there's an audience, I'll definitely do it. If there's not an audience, I may still do it. But it won't be a sure thing. So, hope you enjoyed, and hope you enjoy the